Hi all, here we're going to take a look at finding coterminal angle in radian measure. So all of the angles begin on a positive x-axis here, so that's where 0 radians and 0 degrees begin. And positive angle measures go counterclockwise. Half of the circle rotation is equivalent to pi, which is 180 degrees. And once you complete a whole rotation of a circle, you will have 2 pi, which will be equivalent to 360 degrees. Half of pi, or pi out of 2, which is equivalent to 90 degrees. If you add a pi to that, you would end up with 3 pi out of 2. If you have an angle around here, if you do a full rotation of a circle, you will end up on the same angle. In radians, 360 degrees is 2 pi. So if you have an angle, 2 pi later, you will be at the same location. Every 2 pi, your angle will repeat. So if you have an angle, any angle, you can add or subtract 2 pi to get a measure that is between 0 and 2 pi. And the reason for looking for an angle between 0 and 2 pi, because you want to be able to draw your angle on x and y axis without the repetitions. So let's say you have 3 pi, and 3 pi is clearly more than 2 pi. You would want to subtract a circle, which is 2 pi, and this would give you 1 pi as a coterminal angle. You can also have a negative angle, which is, let's do negative pi out of 4. It's equivalent to negative 45 degree angle, and it would be drawn clockwise at a half of a right angle. So this is our negative pi out of 4. Now, to get a coterminal angle, I would add a circle, so I would add a 2 pi. Now, 2 pi is a whole number we need to add out of 1, because we need a common denominator, so we would multiply 1 by 4. Whatever you do to denominator, you want to do the same thing to numerator, times 4. So now we have negative pi out of 4 plus 4 times 2, 8 pi. The difference between pi and 8 would be 7 pi out of 4. So negative pi out of 4 in clockwise direction is equivalent to 7 pi out of 4 in counterclockwise position. Here we have to find a positive angle less than 2 pi radians that is coterminal with 11 pi out of 5. Now, 5 goes into 11 two whole times, right? So minus 10, and 2 tenths, right? So we have, 11 pi out of 5 is equivalent to 2.2 pi, which is more than 2 pi. If it's more than 2 pi, we're going to take away a circle, we're going to subtract 2 pi. We are taking away 2 pi from a fraction, so we want to have this out of 1. We need a common denominator, which is 5. So we will multiply denominator by 5, whatever you do to denominator, you have to do the same thing to numerator, so times 5. So now we have 11 pi out of 5 minus 5 times 2 is 10 pi. 11 pi minus 10 pi, we have just 1 pi left. Out of 5, which is 1/5 of a pi, this is more than 0 because it's positive and it's less than 2 pi. So pi out of 5 is our solution. In this problem, we have to find a positive angle less than 2 pi that is coterminal with negative 23 pi out of 6. Since this fraction is negative, I will be adding circles to make it into a positive value, which are 2 pi's. But I'm going to divide 6 into 23 just so I know how many whole times 6 goes into 23. 6 goes into 23 3 whole times, and 3 times 6 is 18, and the remainder is 5. 6 will go into 58 times. 8 times 6 gives us 48. What you should take away from this is that 3.8 rounds off to 4. So I will be adding 2 pi to get my positive value, but you will have to do it at least twice. So I'm going to multiply it by 2 over here. But you can totally add 2 pi and then still have your negative value and add 2 pi again. It's not a big deal. So now we have negative 23 pi out of 6 plus 4 pi. And we are adding fractions, so it's out of 1. We need a common denominator, which would be 6. So 1 multiplied by 6. Whatever you do to denominator, you want to do the same thing to numerator. Now we have negative 23 pi plus 24 pi out of 6. The difference between negative 23 and positive 24 is 1. So we have 1 pi out of 6. Pi out of 6 is positive, and it's less than 2 pi, so this is our solution. That's all.